Hey there. So today's question is largest rectangle in a histogram. This is a very important question because this is very frequently asked in interviews. So let's do this question. So in this question, we will be given this kind of histogram, or actually an array whose values denote the height of the bars. So we have to tell the maximum area of the rectangle that can be formed. For example, we have many rectangles here, like this one, all the bars, or maybe this one. So the first method that comes to our mind is brute force, and that is very easy. We have to take every single element and see up to how long we can stretch its rectangle, and we have to store the maximum area possible. We will be taking two pointers. So first the area of rectangle can be this, then the area for the rectangle can be stretched to this also, then the area of the rectangle can be stretched to this also, and then finally to this. As we are moving forward from every element to every element, it is an O(n) square approach, and it is not efficient. But brute force solution is not efficient at all because it is O(n) square. So let's try to think of solution that can be efficient. So let's take a histogram that is not random and it is either increasing or decreasing. So let's first see for the decreasing graph. We are taking a variable maximum area. So we will update our maximum area as 5. Then for this element, we know that the previous element was either greater or equal to this element. So the area will become 4 into 2. So this is 8, so we will update our maximum area. Now for this element, we know that the previous elements were greater than or equal to the value. So this area will become 3 into 3, that is 9. So we will update our maximum area. Now for this element, same. So we know the area have become 2 into 4, that is 8. So we will not update our maximum area. And for this element, it have become 1 into 4. 1 into 5, and that is 5. So we will not update our maximum area. So maximum area we got is 9. And that we got from this histogram. So we got to know in a decreasing histogram, we can easily find the maximum area in one go. Now let's see for an increasing histogram. We can find the maximum area easily in the increasing one as we find in the decreasing one, because we know that all the elements till the end are either greater than or equal to the values. But that is actually using the property of a increasing histogram. Now from the ascending and descending histograms, we got the idea that it is easy to calculate the maximum area when we are going in a particular direction. And the histogram that we have, it is a mixture of ascending and descending both. So let's try to implement these observations. We will be containing maximum values till I. So now let's move forward in our stack and try to find out what are the conditions that we have to implement. Okay. So let's our I is equal to 0 firstly. Initially our stack is empty and maximum height is 0. So when we come at 1, the maximum height will become 1 and we will push 0 in our stack. Then we will move forward. We got 3. 3 is greater than 1, so we will change the maximum height as 3 and we will push 1 in this. So we are pushing the indexes in this stack. Understand that why we have not counted the area for 1 itself when we were at 1, because we know that if the next element is greater than 1, then we can extend this rectangle. So until and unless we don't get any value that is less than 1, we will not be terminating the rectangle for that value. So that's why we are storing all the values that are increasing in our stack. Okay? Now we go to the next value, and that is 2. The value 2 is less than 3 that was at the top of the stack. So we know that we can't extend the rectangle of 3 any further. So we can just calculate the area for this rectangle. So it will be height of I into, but one was clear as what one was, but one was clear to us visually. We know that it is of 1 unit, but how can we find it numerically? So we can say that as we are at 2 right now, we have to take the current position minus the position at which it was starting. So our position was 2 and the value for I was 1, so it is 3. So until now our maximum area was 0, so we will update it to 3. As the part of 2 is in 3 also, so we will not update our stack, but our maximum height now is 2 because we have calculated for 3, so it is gone now. Now we come to the next value, that is 1. So it is less than maximum height, so we know that we can't extend its rectangle further. So we will calculate the area of rectangle now. So area of the rectangle will be height. So our height is 2 and our position is 3 and our I is 1. So it become 4. So as our maximum area is less than 4, so we will update our maximum area to 4. Now we will update our maximum height to 1 and we will remove all the values that are greater than 1. So we removed 1 as the height of 0 is also 1. Now we will move forward. So height for 4 is 2 and it is less than 1. So we will push it in our stack. So we pushed it in our stack and we will move forward. And when we will move forward, we will get to know that our array is empty. So for 4, the area will be same. Height of I into position minus I. So it will be height at 4 is 2 and our position is 5 and I is 4. So it is 2. So maximum area is greater than 2. So we will not update our maximum area. So we will remove this value. Now area for 0. So same height of I. So height of 0 is 1 and our position is 5 and the value of I is 0. So it becomes 5. So 5 is greater than maximum area. So our maximum area finally becomes 5. So by this method, by only iterating once through our histogram, we got to know that the maximum area of a rectangle that we can form is 5. So I hope this is clear. So I hope now you can understand the solution. If you are finding it difficult to understand the solution, try to give it a little more thought because this is obviously a difficult question. And the question for tomorrow is generate parentheses. Don't forget to try it. The link to the codes for this problem in both C++ and Python are in description below. Do give it a look. Also subscribe to the channel and I will see you guys tomorrow with a new solution. Bye.